The Bible climaxes with a parade of transformed nations led by their political leaders in Revelation 21. That is going to happen because it's in the scripture. It is written. It cannot be changed. The question is, how will it happen? Well, I don't know the full answer to that, but I can tell you it has begun to happen. This documentary is about five entrepreneurs that are taking the presence and the power of God to the marketplace every day and experiencing personal transformation, transformation in their family, in their business, and in their industry. And that is then the end, that is the beginning, because they are going for nations. Welcome to Transformation in the Marketplace through Kingdom Entrepreneurs.
Bahadir Yahyagul, Managing Director, Midfield Hong Kong Limited.
And his core business is the manufacturing of kitchen and bath cabinets for mainly New York market. And we have been quite dominant in North American market.
Michael Brown, Founder, Michael's Transportation.
God has blessed me, has blessed my family, have blessed my business. I think we were probably doing maybe not even $2 million in revenue back in 2002. Well, today we're pushing $8-9 million.
Alex Noriega, EDC Manufacturing Services.
I'm dedicated to manufacturing. I do contract manufacturing here in Mexico. With most of my customers are in the United States. And I do electronics, textiles, general assemblies.
Matthew Park, International Insurance Broker, Integrity Insurance Group.
We just picked up a brokerage account and a contract that we're going to be selling insurance through that now just opened up Canada, South America, Mexico, and most of Asia for our ability to do business.
Patney Wu, Director, Central Textiles.
I'm now in a position whereby the industry sees me as a leader in sustainability. That's not just here in Hong Kong. It's actually given me influence globally in the sustainability discussion.
These five men will demonstrate to us that we can change the world beginning with our own sphere of influence.
And the reason they were selected is that they are leading transformation enterprises that are both successful businesses in their own right, market leaders, industry leaders in their own right, but transformational in the sense of the way that they are touching their industries, their cities, and their nations.
Transformational entrepreneurs always start with a clear vision from the Lord.
So the mission and vision of Integrity Insurance Group is to transform the insurance industry and contribute to the transformation of individuals, businesses, cities, and nations.
Midfield for us today represents a company that is the core of the field. And this core of the field belongs to God, and it's God's business. And we see that at the four corners of the midfield, there are four peers that allows the company to pour out to the community.
I believe that God has called me to make a difference in corporate America, and he's using my business transportation as a vehicle.
And I really felt that God was speaking to me about this, about the environment and about taking care of his creation. And I also remembered Proverbs 16:9, which says, in his heart, the man decides what he does, but the Lord would determine his steps. So I said in a prayer, yes, Lord, in my heart, I agree to take care of that rubbish for you, whatever it is.
Once kingdom entrepreneurs have God's vision, they are quick to identify and respond to the felt needs of their community.
The felt needs that are out there in the marketplace are huge. They can be intimidating. But you know, the Lord already knows this because he told us that he will give to us the keys of the kingdom, and the gates of Hades shall not prevail against us. And what we see in these stories is that these entrepreneurs found a key. It was a small key. They faced a huge gate, but it was the key of the kingdom. And they found a method, a way to go about meeting that felt need that unlocked those doors and allowed the kingdom of God to come into the marketplace.
Wall Street Journal came out with a survey of 100 insurance agents here in 2012. 72% admitted to making unethical decisions based on client interaction. I mean, 72%. That's crazy. So when you talk about what's the need for the insurance industry, integrity is at the core of transformation.
In China alone, there was about 3.5 billion yards of denim fabric being made every year. And you only need about 1.5 yards to make a pair of jeans. So you're looking at maybe equivalent, good for 2 billion pairs of jeans every year coming out of China. And when you put a fabric through a garment house, they cut it into the shapes that can make the pair of jeans. You have about 15% that is wasted as cut and sew waste that falls onto the ground. So when you put 15% against 3.5 billion, it's 500 million yards of cut and sew waste that is generated. And when we calculated it, that is enough to go around the world 16 times.
Because I think we live in a society of abundance, you know, and that there's enough to go around, and we can do better than what we've done thus far. But again, we have to change our thinking. We have to start thinking about what's in it for us instead of what's in it for me.
In China, the tapestry of the family has been broken. Families are ripped apart between farmers and migrant workers, and children don't live together with their parents for many, many years. And that has brought many social problems together with it in growing, fast-growing China today.
Every entrepreneur who is focused on the kingdom develops a strategy that improves the quality of life for their community.
When transformational entrepreneurs build companies, they build companies that affect the communities they live in, the industry silo in which they operate, and their nations.
A transformational entrepreneur will identify areas in the marketplace that is inconsistent with the kingdom of God.
We have refused to employ migrant workers, however skilled they might be, because we wanted the core family to stay together. We didn't think that it would be a big impact at the very beginning, but we realized after 7 years down the road, almost 80% of our employee went out and took a mortgage from a local bank, they bought an apartment, and parents are living together.
We continue helping the school, the orphanage, the rehabilitation centers, but something that for me is very important is that we are supporting students that don't have the money to go to college. We are doing the scholarships to them. And the compromise, the commitment that we are asking those guys to do is just to repeat the pattern.
You know, I had sold my business to my employees. And that was a way of, I think, addressing the economic imbalance that is in our economic system. You have to allow labor to participate on the capital side of investment in order to bring equity, I think, to the imbalance that we have between the have and the have-nots.
What we need is a balanced approach where we are able to balance out finance, society and the environment together in what we call a balanced triple bottom line developmental model.
Kingdom entrepreneurs continually strive for excellence, knowing that it will bring recognition in their sphere of influence.
In the parable of the miners, in Luke chapter 19, Jesus tells us that the master gave people investment capital, as these entrepreneurs have received ideas, concepts, and they invested and they succeeded. And because they succeeded, they were recognized and they were given influence. You see, excellence brings influence. And this is what these men have achieved.
The work of the Sustainable Fashion Business Consortium has really caught the eye of the industry. And that's why I've been invited onto a lot of boards and within Hong Kong to look at the future direction of the textile industry here in Hong Kong.
I've been blessed to be given the Twin Cities Finest Award for Young Entrepreneurship. Now 3 years in a row, Integrity Insurance Group has been honored as one of the premier insurance agencies in the state of Minnesota.
Our credibility of following and pursuing the sustainability and how we execute our production comes from the contracts that we're able to sign in so far. We're responsible for infitting more than 2,000 apartments, brand new apartments in Manhattan alone. And every one of these buildings are certified for LEED Gold or beyond.
I spoke with the president of the company and said, why you choose us and why you did that? And say, because Alex, we were looking around and we all had the same conclusion that there is nobody else to trust than your company.
We are very good at what we do, and no, not in a boastful way, but I think we're the best, actually. And so it's not a surprise to me that people are calling us and asking us, can you help us?
To bring about change, entrepreneurs first need to experience personal transformation.
What we see in these stories is a progression. First, a personal transformation, answering the call, saying I'm all in. Second, their families were touched and transformed. Thirdly, their companies, and then from there, their industries. But they are not stopping there. When you hear their passion, they are going for the world.
You give a man a fish, you feed him for a day, you teach him how to fish, he feeds his family for a lifetime. You sell him the pond, you change the face of corporate America forever and begin to close the gap between the have and the have-nots.
God has equipped us with such amazing skills that rather than us changing ourselves to become the head of the industry in different areas, we're finding that other companies are following the path that we had opened up. So we're not trying to climb up a ladder and sit on top of a big pyramid. We're seeing that the pyramid is built behind us and we are becoming the head but not the tail, because we're being followed, we're not following.
I was invited by the legislative councillor who represents our industry to chair the sustainability subcommittee. And now we are looking at forming a sustainability hub here in Hong Kong, where we will be the knowledge base for the whole of Asia.
We've come up with a lot of innovative ideas in this industry that are actually cutting edge. That is allowing us to tap a greater market share. And I believe it's just because of our relationship with our call on our lives, and that we are not just called to disciple individuals, but I believe that God has called us to disciple and mentor a industry, and then in doing so, ultimately, the nation.
Transformational companies embrace a kingdom methodology, allowing for maximum influence and lasting change.
When I think about building a transformational company, I think about what does my methodology look like? And to me, the methodology consists of practicing prayer evangelism as my customer relationship management strategy and operating according to the five pivotal paradigms.
So every time the phone rings, every time we go see somebody, we have the opportunity to really engage in prayer evangelism. And so that is an exciting aspect of our business. On any given week, we probably converse with over 500 people. So we have the opportunity to be talking and blessing and speaking peace and witnessing and ministering to felt needs on a daily basis.
Our dream place to be is that the nation, the province will understand that five paradigms and prayer evangelism is a key for converting businesses to give back to the community and thriving the community on a reverse cycle, and that is a solution for China.
So prayer evangelism is one of the biggest tools that we have as entrepreneurs, as a business people, to help change the spiritual environment in our area of influence.
Kingdom thinkers never despise the day of small beginnings, because they dream with God and trust for the transformation of nations.
Now that you've seen these five amazing stories, the key takeaway here is they're not the end, they're the beginning. There are young men and women all over the world that have a desire in their heart not only to be successful in whatever business God's called them to, but to do something transformational, to reach their city, their nation, their industry with the kingdom of God.
We are planting a seed that very, very soon is gonna grow, and we're gonna see the harvest out of that.
I'm 5 years on in the journey. There's been tremendous amount of fruits already, but it is still a small beginning. But I definitely feel that this is the right track, and I have to stay close to God to see it come into fruition. It will be my life's work.
Whether your beginning is big or small like mine was, remember you are an ordinary person with a potential to do extraordinary things for God. And ultimately, nothing short of nation transformation will do.
This could well be the beginning of that stone not cut by human hands that Daniel saw in his vision, that is thrust against the statue that represents the Babylonian system, and it hits it in the most vulnerable place where the clay and the iron cannot be mixed. And I believe, as I explain in my book Transformation, that clay is populism. It's what politicians cultivate. Promise people whatever they want, because that way is how you win the election. But it's not sustainable. What we are seeing here is an alternative to the Babylonian system. We are seeing, and these are just five of many people, that in every continent, in every culture, I mean, this is not industry specific. This is the river of God that is beginning to move. We are seeing people that they are striking the Babylonian system, and they are replacing it with something better. You know what the next step is? Now for more people to join the movement. For you, if you feel validated by this, you are called by God to receive a leaf from the tree of life, to meet a felt need, to bring healing to something that is making your industry sick. And when we do that, we will be able to see that stone grow into a mountain, and eventually that mountain will fill the earth. And the Lord will descend in glory, and the nations of the earth will welcome him, because somebody said, "Yes, Lord, I'm all in."